Dear students, today we are going to see in the lesson kinematics the important topics are this is the session 5 projectile motion, horizontal projection, degrees and radian, angular displacement and centripetal acceleration. What is this projectile motion? When an object is thrown in the air with some initial velocity, that means not just upwards, and then allowed to move under the action of gravity alone, the object is known as projectile. The path followed by the particle is called trajectory. See, some of the examples of projectiles are, first one is an object dropped from the window of a moving train. Second one, a bullet fired from a rifle. Third one, a ball thrown in any direction. Fourth one, a javelin or a shot put thrown by an athlete. Fifth one, a jet of water issuing from a hole near the bottom of a water tank. These are the some of the examples you can see in your day-to-day life. And these are the best examples of projectiles. And it's found that a projectile moves under the combined effect of two velocities. Remember, they have two velocities, and the velocities are a uniform velocity in the horizontal direction, which will not change provided there is no air resistance, and the second one, a uniformly changing velocity, that means it increasing or decreasing in the vertical direction. Because why we are taking this vertical direction as a important thing is the vertical direction is depends upon the gravitational force. To study the motion of a projectile, let us assume that air resistance is neglected and the effect due to the rotation of earth and the curvature of earth is here negligible. Then the acceleration due to gravity is constant in magnitude and direction at all the points of the motion of the projectile. Now we are going to see the projectile in horizontal projection. Students, can you see this picture? It has an horizontal projection. We are throwing a ball from a certain height, and you can see the height variation here. Okay, and the timing and the velocities of x and y. From the meter per second, in the vx, velocity in the x axis and the velocity in the y axis. Okay, here the velocity gets positive when it goes up and negative when it goes down. Can you see? Now let's move to the question. Let a ball thrown from the top of the height, which is minus h, and with the initial velocity minus u. As the ball moves, it covers a horizontal distance. Remember, this is the horizontal distance. due to its uniform horizontal velocity u, and a vertical downward distance because of a constant acceleration due to gravity, which I mentioned you earlier, and take time t to reach the ground at the point A. So then the horizontal distance traveled by a ball is x in time t is equal to x, and the vertical distance traveled by the ball y in time t is equal to y. Remember, this is the vertical distance traveled and this is the horizontal distance traveled. Now, motion along horizontal direction. The particle has zero acceleration along x direction, so the initial velocity ux remains constant throughout the motion. The distance traveled by the projectile at the time t is given by the equation, which you know already, the using the equation of motion, x equal to ux t plus 1 by 2 at square. Here this is the initial velocity and this is the time and this is the acceleration with respect to the time. Since the acceleration is zero along the x direction because there is no acceleration in the horizontal direction, so if you put a equal to zero in this equation, then the equation becomes x is equal to ux into t, because instead of zero it becomes zero. Remember, we can apply the kinetic equation along the x direction and y direction separately. Since this is two-dimensional motion, the velocity will have both horizontal component u and the vertical component u y. So here the initial velocity during the downward direction uy is equal to 0 and a is equal to g. That means the acceleration is with respect to the gravity of the earth, and the distance y at time t is equal to, from the equation of y is equal to uy t plus 1 by 2 at square, we get here the u is equal to 0, so we neglect u. Okay, so y is equal to 1 by 2 into gt square. And substituting the value of t from the equation 1 in equation 2, we have y is equal to 1 by 2 g into x square by ux square, and which we can write as g into 2 ux square into x square, or you can put y equal to x square, taking this g by 2 ux square as k, and this is the equation number 3, and the k is equal to g by 2 ux square is a constant, and this equation y is equal to k x square is called the equation of a parabola. Now let's see what's the time of flight, because it's very important to know the time of flight. Let us consider the example of a tower and a projectile, which we saw in the slides earlier. Let h be the height of the tower, let t be the time taken by the projectile to hit the ground, and after being thrown horizontally from the tower, the time taken for the projectile to complete its trajectory, as I mentioned earlier, trajectory or a time taken by the projectile to hit the ground is called the time of flight. Okay, so time taken by the projectile to hit the ground is called time of flight. So, as we know, Sy is equal to uyt plus 1 by 2 at square for vertical motion. Here, Sy is equal to height, right? And t is equal to capital T, and uy is equal to 0. The initial vertical velocity is 0. Then we have h is equal to 1 by 2 gt square, or t is equal to, this is the time of flight, t is equal to root of 2h by g. Can you remember, if you take this t here and if you take this g by h, then 2 up in this left hand side, then 2h by g, and if you take the square root from the right side, then it becomes the root of 2h by g. See, thus the time of flight for projectile motion depends upon the height of the tower, but is independent of the horizontal velocity of projection. Now, let's see the horizontal range. The horizontal distance covered by the projectile from the foot of the tower to the point where the projectile hits the ground is called the horizontal range, and it is noted by the equation of motion Sx is equal to uxt plus 1 by 2 at square. So we put Sx is equal to r, that means the range, ux is equal to u, and a is equal to 0 because there is no horizontal acceleration, and capital T is the time of flight. When we substitute all these values of Sx, ux, a and t in this equation, then we get the horizontal range r is equal to u into capital T, because when you put a is equal to 0 here, this equation becomes this set becomes totally 0. So remaining Sx is equal to uxt, and while substituting the values of r about r, u and t, we get horizontal range is equal to u into t. Since we know the time of flight, which is t is equal to root of 2h by g, and we substitute this and we get the horizontal range of the particle as r is equal to u into root of 2h by g. Remember, this above equation implies that the range r is directly proportional to the initial velocity u and inversely proportional to the acceleration due to gravity g. Now we move to an important equation of motion, range and maximum height reached by the particle thrown at an oblique angle with, which is theta, with respect to the horizontal direction. Let me introduce a new picture here. When a ball moves in this direction, you can deem this ball as a football, okay, which when a player kick the ball here, it travels in a vertical direction and then it settles in the horizontal direction. And by moving the vertical direction, uy is equal to sin theta, and while reaching the horizontal direction, it has ux is equal to u cos theta. Here, the ay is equal to minus g. That means the projection, it moves to a certain height or range, but it has a gravity of minus because it leaves the earth after reaching the certain heights in the vertical direction. Consider an object thrown with initial velocity u vector at an angle theta with the horizontal. Then u is equal to u vector is equal to uxi plus uyj, where ux is equal to u cos theta is the horizontal component, and uy is equal to u sin theta. This is the vertical component of the velocity, which I mentioned earlier using the picture. Now, ux remains constant throughout the motion. Okay, it remains constant throughout the motion. Uy changes with time under the effect of acceleration due to gravity, because you can see the acceleration due to gravity differences while it moves in this vertical direction. First, it decreases and becomes zero at the maximum height, after which it again increases till the cross reach the ground. Hence, after a time t, the velocity along the horizontal motion is equal to vx is equal to ux plus ax into t. So ux is equal to u cos theta, that you know. Now the horizontal distance traveled by the projectile in time t is, from the equation of motion, we put sx is equal to uxt plus 1 by 2 ax into t square. And we know sx is equal to x and ux is equal to u, and cos theta and ax is equal to 0, because here the acceleration due to gravity becomes 0. So the equation becomes, why substitute the values of sx, ux and ax, we get x is equal to u cos theta into t, or t is equal to x by u cos theta, which is the equation number 1. Next, for the vertical motion, so far we have seen here the horizontal distance traveled by the projectile. Now let's move to the vertical motion. In the vertical motion, vy is equal to uy plus ay into t. So we know uy is equal to u sin theta and ay is equal to minus g, which I mentioned earlier. Acceleration due to gravity acts opposite to the motion, and substituting all these values of uy and ay, we get vy is equal to u sin theta minus gt. This is the equation number 2. Then the vertical distance traveled by the projectile in the same time t is sy is equal to uyt plus 1 by 2 ay into t square. While substituting the values of sy is equal to y and uy is equal to u sin theta and ax is equal to minus g, then we get y is equal to u sin theta t minus 1 by 2 gt square. This is equation number 3. We can substitute the values of t from equation number 1 in the equation number 3, which we received here. We have y is equal to u sin theta x by u cos theta minus 1 by 2 g into x square u square cos square theta. And finally, this sine and cos values can combine together. So y is equal to x tan theta minus 1 by 2 g into x square divided by u square cos square theta. Thus, the path followed by the projectile is an inverted parabola. Let's see what's the maximum height, which is denoted as h max. The maximum vertical distance traveled by the projectile or a ball during its journey is called the maximum height. Imagine when a footballer hits the ball, it travels to a maximum height, but at the end it reaches in the opposite goalpost. Okay, so the maximum height traveled is called the maximum height here. This is determined as follows. For the vertical part of the motion, we get Vy square is equal to Uy square plus 2ay into s. And we take Uy is equal to u sin theta, and a is equal to minus g, and s is equal to h max, that means the maximum height. Vy is equal to 0. While substituting these values in the equation, we get, while substituting Vy is equal to 0, it becomes 0 square, and u, instead of Uy square, we put u square sin square theta, and which is equal to a is equal to minus g. So we take this g to the right hand side, which is equal to 2gh max, or the h max is equal to u sin square theta divided by 2g. We get this 2g down the u square sin square theta. This is the maximum height we received while the ball travel vertical distance during the projectile motion. And we are going to see the time of flight for this projectile motion, which is an inverted parabola. The total time taken by the projectile from the point of projection till it hits the projected horizontal plane is called the time of flight. This time of flight is the time taken by the projectile to go from point O to B via the point A. If you refer the picture in your book, then you can find it very easy. And as we know, Sy is equal to Uyt plus 1 by 2 Ayt square, which is in the vertical direction. That means the time of flight in the vertical direction. And if you put Sy is equal to y, which is equal to 0, that means the net displacement in the y direction is 0. Can you accept this? Yeah, because even though, I think you all can see the cursor, even though it travels to a certain height, okay, at the end, the height, the vertical direction, the height is not being saved here. At last, it reaches the ground. So, the height it reaches becomes 0. That's why we put Sy or y is equal to 0. The net displacement in y direction is 0, UY is equal to U sin theta and AY is equal to minus G and T is equal to capital T into F, then we get, instead of SY 0 and instead of UY we put U sin theta and instead of T we put TF, and which is we have a minus here because the AY is equal to minus G, so minus 1 by 2 G TF square, or if you take this TF square then the time of flight, okay, TF is equal to 2U sin theta by G. We take this 2 here, okay, and the G becomes a inverted. Let's see what's the horizontal range of this inverted parabola. The maximum horizontal distance between the point of projection and the point of horizontal plane where the projectile hits the ground is called the horizontal range R. This is found easily since the horizontal component of initial velocities remain same. We can write range R is equal to horizontal component of velocity into time of flight, which is equal to U TF cos theta. R is equal to U cos theta into 2U sin theta divided by G, which we also know, and if you substitute it in 1, then 2U square, here we have 2U and here we have 1U, so 2U square sin theta and cos theta divided by G. Finally, we know sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta and R is equal to U square sin 2 theta divided by G. Thank you students, thank you for your support, study well.